It's my pleasure to introduce the one of my grad students, Chelsea Toyer, who is working on anti-aging anti-wrinkling properties of some plants. And he saw the first part of my area of research, which is anti-aging anti-wrinkling properties of some plants. And those two young ladies working together, and Chile is Chelsea is working on some plants that she will tell you, she'll explain to you, and it's all part of the same project that I told you earlier. Chelsea is all yours.
Thank you. I'm Chelsea Toyer, and I'm doing a research right now on the evaluation of anti-aging life activity in China. So, the objectives of this research project is for us to analyze the vitamin C and E content of the tiger nut. And we will also want to compare both the tiger nut and the chili pepper, and then just present on those two contents to see the levels of those, which concentration happened. So, I want to give a little history background about some ways that people have been using to turn, you know, the clock around to look more evil. So, some things that people were using was alkaline, which is where they use different type of metals, and they'll use them as an ornament, or they'll adjust them as bills. They thought this would keep them young. Another thing is that people use is glass, which were extracts from reproductive organs of female and male organs. And they'll also use cell injections. The cell injections were from tissues of newborn fetus animals. As stated before, the plant organic-based products are growing. This is expected to be a $54 billion industry expected in 2025. So the reason being is because plants have different antioxidants that are in. And here, as you can see, I have a little graph that the reason antioxidants help us is because of free radicals. A free radical is basically an unstabilized molecule. Is where there's an unpaired electron on the outer shell. And when it's unpaired, it will go around causing damage in the DNA as well as other cell structures. And that's what causes premature aging. This happens naturally, and this can also be caused just because of smoking, genetics. We can't stop it, but we can slow it down. So some background information about tiger nut, cypress, and plants. Actually not a nut, it's a tuber. It's grown underground as we see here, and they like to grow it by itself in those rows you see there because it will outcompete other plants. It will compete for nutrients as well as water. It's a wheat-like structure and grew up to 1 to 2 years, and it was originally cultivated in Africa, West Africa, as well as Mediterranean areas. It's currently being cultivated in tiger nut is known as a superfood. In many countries, they will use this to make their milk, as in horchata tutupa, which is popular in Spain. They also make a similar milk in West Africa. It's really high in vitamins and minerals, and it has more starch than potato. There have been some more studies on the anti-aging-like properties of the tiger nut, and some of those studies have been used to look at the food source antioxidants. Not really having looked on like anti-aging-like properties, but there are some. So the two vitamins that we observed were the vitamin C and E. Reason being is because vitamin C is a water-soluble antioxidant, helps fade brown spots on the skin, and it helps reduce the oxidative stress, like I said before, with the free radicals. We observed vitamin E, and it's a fat-soluble antioxidant. And it stops the production of ROS formed when fat undergoes oxidation. So some methods and the procedures that we did for this experiment is that we took our tiger nut bulbs, we took 2 grams of our tiger nut, weighed it out, and we homogenized that in 20 milliliters of distilled water. We filtered that through a cheesecloth to get any of the large particles out, and then we centrifuged it. Centrifuge is a machine where it rapidly spins our incorporates it into the soup and the pellet. The soup is what we're going to be analyzing. It's the top half, which is the liquid portion of it. And that's where we analyze the vitamin C as well as E. So for the procedure for vitamin C, if you were here yesterday, you heard the spectrophotometrically. We use that machine to analyze and measure the absorbency of the vitamin C contents. This procedure may be used for the reduction of absorbency of potassium permanganate and the solution reacted with vitamin C in the acid medium. So this procedure helped us to identify the color indication. So the color change within each of the series that we ran as well as the tagline, that means there was a presence of vitamin C content in this procedure. For vitamin E, we did a similar procedure, which we also used the spectrophotometrically. Prior to those methods, and in those procedures, we measure the oxidation production of the ferric chloride when reacted with vitamin E in the ethanolic medium. We did this 3 or 4 times. Here you can see our different series. I did 5 series as well as liquid titanate. The color change indicated if there was a presence of the vitamin E. So for our vitamin C, this is my standard curve and the concentrations of my vitamin C. We use ascorbic acid in different concentration levels in the different series, 1 through 5. Using that formula, we're going to be able to determine the concentrations of our vitamin C content in our samples. We need to do more analyzation of this specific data and further studies. For my vitamin E content, I was able to get my standard curve concentrations of the tocopherol, which is the pure vitamin E that we use to do our standard series. Doing this, we were able to find our concentrations of our vitamin E content of the tigranet. Here is the actual test that I ran. We see right here on the right hand, on the left hand side, that I ran 5 different tests of our tigranet. And we check the absorbency of the vitamin E. Using my standard curve, I was able to find out the actual concentration of the vitamin E content. In the cuvette, you can see there was 2.6 micrograms per milliliter, and that's basically telling us how much vitamin E was in our tigranet when we ran the spectrophotometrically the absorbency. Also, in our exact extract, we were able to see that there was 6.848 milligrams per milliliter of the vitamin extract. And then overall, in our tigranet, the dry weight, we were able to see that within that measurement, this is how much vitamin E is in that content. There are further tests that we're going to be analyzing to actually find more specific measurements. This is just a small analysis overall. I did want to thank the biology department for allowing me to be a graduate student and also as Dr.